Welcome to the Holocaust. That was not a collapse. That was a nervous breakdown. It is interesting to note that out of the four lowest impact players of the series, three were Indians, batting at the number 1, 3 and 4 position, namely Shikhar Dhawan or Gautam Gambhir, Cheteshwar Pujara and Virat Kohli. When your top order fails like that, no team has a chance in hell to do well in a series. In fact, Virat Kohli was the lowest impact player of the series. Even England's number 11, James Anderson, had a higher batting impact than him.
5 points someone, the three mistakes of my life, two states, one night at a call center, half girlfriend. Is Virat Kohli Indian cricket's Chetan Bhagat?
With the exception of Murali Vijay, the Indian openers had pretty much a 100% failure rate, which would mean Dhawan and Gambhir. And if you added Kohli to that list, then you have failures from three Delhi boys.
And we all thought Delhi guys are good at scoring.
We have this thing called new ball impact, which measures the impact of a batsman who plays out the new ball, both in terms of balls faced and runs scored. And after Murali Vijay, guess who India's highest impact new ball impact player is? It's MS Dhoni, who came into bat at number 6 and once at number 7. This tells you how abjectly the Indian top order failed in this series.
England's youth brigade had them going in the series. There was Joe Root, Joss Butler, Gary Ballance, Moeen Ali. Basically the reason behind England's dominance in this series.
Broad and Anderson had a 0% failure rate in the series. This, in fact, was James Anderson's first series-defining performance of his career and by far his finest.
Alistair Cook in this series very famously said that Anderson is the best English bowler of all time. Well, according to Impact Index, he is the 10th highest impact English bowler in their Test cricket history. In fact, someone from his team is a higher impact bowler than him, Stuart Broad.
The English bowlers this series topped every bowling parameter there was except the partnership breaking one. Why? Because India barely managed to forge any partnerships.
Ishan Sharma, he also topped the pressure building impact charts, which is when a bowler gets two or more batsmen out in quick succession, putting the batting team under pressure, which was mainly the reason also behind India's win at Lords.
Bhuvaneshwar Kumar was the next highest impact bowler for India in the series. We feel sorry for him, but his body was simply not cut out for a 5-match test series.
Interestingly, Rabindra Jadeja and Bhuvaneshwar Kumar were the only all-rounders in the series. England had no all-rounders. Their specialist did it for them. Moeen Ali changed his specialization.
Should cricketers around the world now wear wristbands that say, Save India?